Welcome to our weekend series. Today we're going to talk about headship. Headship, heading the church, the family, and so on. We'll take some few minutes to go through the scriptures. What do we mean by headship? When we say headship, it also means a servant in leadership. Headship is a responsibility to assume with humility and not a right to demand with pride. Therefore, se kasi edi adie so a enya adie e kasi edi ma ye honso ne mum e kwan mum ye fa so e de bre ye ho ase. As defined in scripture, it is first assigned to the husband during the act of creation as part of pre-fall perfection. The man was created first. When we look through Genesis chapter 2 verse 7, let's read Genesis 2:7. Genesis chapter 2 verse 7 tells us that. Genesis 2:7 says, "And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living being." Hallelujah. Therefore, Bible mayeti asye se onyankopon edin kan e na obo bema na obo no se obedi ebusua no so na obehwe se eniema ebetoto yie na nti ehwe Mose uma edi kan Genesis na yehun se onyankopon ebo bema na odini emenyina ehye nensa. And the woman was created as his helper, so that he would not be alone in his dominion over the world. And we see that in Genesis chapter 2, verse 18. And unto Obanon so onyakopon bono ka bema no se onbeye ne se so boa fo. And unto Oba ebe ka onyakopon shishe ye hun. Now, or kahunsi saying so. Na na and she shall say O Bambeka Bema hum se be ya umbinyan kita hundi and I say Bonibekas a fellowship umbinyan kita hundi na omukita hundi no e de enfaswani susan so abre a chiriman so. And so the woman was created as his helper so that he would not be alone in his dominion over the world. And to say the abeya obe mankwa en ononkwa se onono oshwe abodye so anase odi adye so no ononkwa en timi ento nyankopon ebo nise sobwa fo edemano na se di abeya oba ebe kan awonto atwa so edumedie nina hon. And doing the work assigned by God. When we look through Genesis chapter 1, verses 26 and 26 to 28, we see that there. So that woman will also be part of God's plan of fellowship. You see, Obabe kan hun, Emma, Onyanko ponchi sheya, washi shafa, ngita hundienu, etimi, abemu. This is further verified when Adam is vested with the ultimate responsibility for disobedience because he received the directive concerning the forbidden fruit from God himself. Eve was only aware of the command through her husband. And so we see all these verses, which you can later have time to look through, search the scriptures. This weekend, Genesis chapter 1, verses 26 to 28, and then Genesis chapter 2, 15 to 17, 1 Timothy 2:14. Enti Adam di onu ji kansa sudie ni fi Nyankopon chen. Na ono no Eve die Adam ne bo na mane. Enu nti ena de nyina ye kan ye hu ne se bema no kwan bi so no wanye na adwuma yie. Oye na adwuma yie mpo ese obo oba na mane ne mom se oba no kofa ba ya ono su gidi ye. Nani nyina ekyire ye behwe ehu ensunsanso. Nti ene ye di besi ha. So later we'll look through all these. We are saying that the mistake came from Adam. What do you also think? Because he got a direct instruction from God. Eve was only informed. And she only became aware of the command through her husband. And so we say that Adam made a mistake because although he told her, he also accepted what Eve brought to him. So discuss this in your various homes with your husband, your children, your wife, your children, your brothers, your sisters. And then inbox us. Let's see your reaction. So we'll meet next week. Bye-bye. See you next year. And then I watch you in Subiu. Bye-bye. Nyami in Shonokaum. Have a fruitful weekend.